Hi guys, happy Monday. It is a new week, hopefully a little bit closer to us being back in here with you all. So you have a workout today and some mid-length work, so we're going to get nice and warm for that. So we warm up together for 4 minutes, we're going to hit rounds, just getting nice and warm for those 4 minutes. You're going to start on 8 unweighted lunges each leg with a reach up. So I'm going to step out, back knee to the floor, reach up nice and high as well. Change legs, 8 each leg, or 8 one leg, 8 the other, however you want to split that. Then 20 toe touches, so nice wide stance, and over, touching each toe, getting a good rotation through that trunk. Then 10 air squats, and then finishing your round with 5 down and up, so you're half burpee, not going chest to the floor. That is one round, maybe 4 minutes, just keep churning through rounds of that until you're nice and warm. Then our workout is 3 rounds of 1 minute max reps on 4 movements, and then you're going to have a minute's rest. So every round is going to be 5 minutes, and then it's a 15 minute workout, but you've got 3 minutes rest built in that. It's all going to be like volume if we can today. So it is going to depend a little bit on the weight that you have at home. And what you've got to use. So if it's a little bit heavier, then you're not going to get as high volume, you might need to break. But ideally, we just want to keep churning 3 reps on this. So your first movement is going to be power cleans. So if you've got a barbell, we'll be taking the bar from the floor up into the front, back down, 1 minute, as many reps as you can. So it's kind of an option on this workout, whether you want it to be a dumbbell or kettlebell workout, or if you've got a bar, you can jump on that. So if you've got a bar, power cleans, reps for a minute, you have the option with a bar how heavy that is. I would not go too heavy on this. I would rather you keep churning out reps rather than hit 3, have to break. So that's kind of the stimulus we're looking for here. Go lighter, get some more volume, and try and keep moving. If you have 2 dumbbells that are the same weight, then with your power cleans, you can touch the floor, bring them up into the front rack, back down again, keep those moving. If you've only got 1 dumbbell or kettlebell, we're going to hit the floor, bring it up into that front rack, keep moving through those reps, changing arms whenever you want to, and try and keep it nice and even between those arms on that. So that's your first minute. Your second minute is going to be front squats. So if you have a barbell, you can chuck that in the front rack, sit into your squat as many reps as you can. If you have 2 dumbbells or kettlebells the same weight, they're going to be in the front rack, hit your squats there. If you have 1, bring it up into the front rack, work through your squats, change arms whenever you want to. Minute 3, as many reps as you can push press. So if you have a barbell, chuck it in the front rack, dip, drive up overhead. If you have a dumbbell or kettlebell, if you've got 2 from here, dip up. If you have 1 from here, use that drive and keep working through those reps, changing arms, keeping it nice and even between both. And then your fourth minute is going to be overhead lunges. So this is where, if we're using a barbell, you want to pick up your kettlebell or dumbbell for this movement. And we're only going to use 1 weight for this. So you're going to clean it up, press it out overhead, and from here, stepping out, alternating legs, change arms whenever you want, trying to keep the arm holding the weight nice and locked out overhead, so as many reps as you can. And then we're going to have a minute's rest. So 4 minutes back to back. If you can, try and count how many reps you get as like a rolling total. So if you get 20 power cleans in your minute, start your front squats on 21. So by the time you get to that 5th minute, you've got a number. And then for the next 2 rounds, that's a bit of a benchmark to aim for, instead of just kind of blindly going into it each round and not having a clue where you are. So that'll give you something to aim for, see if you can maintain your output. So that's our workout. Then we are going to hit a quarter batter of dead bugs and hollow holds. So 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off, chuck a Tabata someone, if you're doing this on your own and not on Zoom. Find the Tabata song anywhere on YouTube or Spotify. And you're just going to alternate between those 2 movements. So you're starting on dead bugs. So from here, feet hip width apart, lowering to just above the floor. From coming back up, nice and controlled, for 20 seconds. 10 seconds rest, and then you're going to go into a hollow hold. So from here, holding in that dish position, if you need to make it a little easier, bring your arms down or bring your knees in, and just try and hold that. So you've got four sets of each movement, and that is your day.